Hello, welcome to Objective Media. And of course, the local government election in Lagos State has just concluded and the result is already everywhere. APC cleared almost all. The side I'm interested in is where some young persons decided who are saying they want to aspire for the political positions in 2019, but they decided to experiment with the local government election in Lagos State and decided to contest. One of them is Gbadebo Rhodes-Vivour, who contested on the platform of KOWA party for chairmanship in Ikeja, Lagos State. Gbadebo Rhodes-Vivour had expectations before going into the elections. And then during the election, he said he witnessed so many things that he's willing to share with us. And of course, did he regret? Was he happy participating after all, even though he didn't win? He had approximately 700 voters on his side without paying a kobo to anybody, according to him. So we spoke with Gbadebo Rhodes-Vivour, and then he has the following to say about the just concluded local government election in Lagos State.
Actually got into politics because that is the only platform that one can actually bring about change in the affairs of people on a long-term fashion. I mean, NGOs can do that as well, but we need activists, and also we need activist politicians that will actually put the interests of Nigerians first. One would say, I schooled abroad. I went to MIT in the States. I moved back in 2009. Immediately I finished. I have a good idea of what Nigerian politics is. But I am not someone that believes that when a status quo is bad, we should just accept that status quo. You know, we already knew that people will say that there will be a lot of rigging, that LASEC will not conduct a free and fair election, that most of their agents will most likely be party affiliated and all that. So we knew all that. This is normal information. What I aimed to do, which I did quite successfully, if I think about it, because in Ikeja, 3 months ago, 4 months ago, there was no KOWA. There was no KOWA structure. If you said KOWA to somebody, they would say, what is that? You know, but there's no way you're going to go in Ikeja now and say KOWA and they will ask you, what is that, you know? So we built a structure in 3 months that was able to turn out 700 votes. And you compare that to a structure like PDP that was only able to turn out 900. And the voter turnout was very low. Looking at the numbers of the turnout and understanding that even with all the rigging, all the people using other people's voters' cards to vote, and because there were no card readers, that there were still a lot of people that stayed in their houses during elections. And those people are people that will not come out and sell their vote. How could we work to get those people to come out? What can we do in the community to get these people to see that these people are different and they actually want something truly good for a community? Those were the things that I hinged my hope on. 700 people in Ikeja in 3 months is not a joke, because you have to understand each vote was cast with the opportunity cost of collecting money for that vote. And going in, we maintain the principle to all our agents that we are not going to be sharing food on election day, we're not sharing rice on election day, we're not sharing money on election day. We want people that truly want a change in this country to come out and vote. And you find that a lot of people that were passionate about the party and everything came out and actually, what I'll say, they gave us first right of refusal. Look at us, we brought our voters card, we really want to vote for KOWA, but how much are you paying? And they said that because all around people were paying for votes, and nobody wants in Nigeria to say we don't carry last, right? And when we maintain our principle, they then turn back and say, ah, okay, you know, look, someone else has paid us 1.5, so we voted for them. But even at that, I want the polling booth where I vote, I won. And we cannot say that, okay, it's affluent people that live there, because Ikeja is a nice mix, you know. There are people that are working class, there are people that are not so rich, there are people that are decent and not decent in that sense, but they have significant amount of funds or wealth or whatever. But that polling booth, people that voted were Okada riders, you know, people that fry yam on the streets, because we spent time and they believed, you know. And I feel that that was wonderful. I feel that we need to change the demography of voters in Nigeria. That's the way forward. Because the current demography of people that come out to vote has actually been created by the political class. And that demography of people think about the here and now. Now, people that think about the here and now cannot make sustainable decisions. And I just give that, I can give you two very simple examples. And these are examples I give when I was talking to people. But we also have to understand that this kind of thinking is new to this demography. They're not used to politicians talking to them like that, because politicians are not really interested in talking too much. They just want to come and share money, you go do what you're supposed to do, and they will see in 4 years' time. That's what they are used to, and that's what they like. So you also have to understand that this new idea, these new principles were being pushed and imprinted on people that their default is to collect money. And that might also be a mistake for a young party and for new people coming out. We need to change demography by focusing on the young man or young woman that's currently in SS3, that's thinking, that's going to school and wants a better life, that wants to go to university, that wants to go to a university that will get a good education, you know? We need to start thinking about the working class. The working class, they might not be rich, but they are working. They believe in dignity of labor. That's why they wake up every morning and go to work. The drivers, the mechanics, the people that, you know, the guy that is riding that fan milk bike that wakes up every morning and does that. You know, unfortunately, when you talk about politics in Nigeria and even Lagos as a whole, you hear about the thugs, the area boys. That if you talk about getting politics, the first people that people ask you about, what about the area boys? How many thugs do you have on your side? You know? And that is the true problem, because those people, right, no matter what you do for them, the fact that they are dependent, a lot of them are dependent on drugs, they're alcoholics, a lot of them, and their decision making is based always in the moment, in the here and now. And that is their default position. When you talk to them, I've spent a lot of time talking to people like that, and they will tell you that we want jobs, we want something sustainable. But that is because I am talking to them. You also have to understand that there are things that other people are telling them. Nigeria cannot be better. They've given up hope. There's no hope. So they will tell you, someone actually said to me that people always suffer in Nigeria. But if I have the chance to be suffering, but I have a TV, it's better than to just be suffering. So if we are going to suffer anyway, and I can take 1,000 naira and be able to eat today, it's better than to go and vote and we'll all be suffering. So restoring hope is also a major thing that we have to do. But I really, what I've taken from this now is we actually have to aggressively, very aggressively and very deliberately change the demographic of the people that come out to vote. And we need to partner. It's not something that is necessarily a political party thing. It's something that we have to work with everybody that's doing wonderful work. You know, you have budget that's doing tracker, where you have people that are talking and giving feedback on constituency projects, you know, getting involved, bringing that thoroughly to the grassroots, making them see that that is possible. You know, working with Enough is Enough. I know they do a lot of fantastic things with voter education on radio and stuff, but bringing that down to the grassroots and also engaging people. Because the one thing you say stuff on radio and TV and it gets a lot of applause and all of that, right? But then we also have to do that, but we also have to be doing it at the grassroots, knocking on people's doors and talking about good governance, not in election season, now. So this was a fantastic first step. Like I said, 3 months in a place where people did not know about the party. I mean, to get 700 people to commit to coming out to vote under the rain, that is awesome. You know, it's awesome. And when you look at the numbers, when you see PDP pulling 900, you know that when you see a huge number, you look at that number properly. The voter turnout is not, it was not like that. So aside from, we're going to build on that foundation because we're determined to bring a better life to people, at least in Ikeja.
Of course.
You know? You see, we as young people, we need to stop lying to ourselves. I think we spend a lot of time talking amongst ourselves in our echo chambers and lying to ourselves when we really should be out there doing work. We need to do. This whole idea of, it's good. I really respect the people that went and put so much effort into this Not Too Young to Run bill. And I think that they championed a noble cause. But it's very rare to see people that benefit from a political system actually just hand you something that will empower you. The politician that knows that he can get area boys to come out and do his bidding does not want those area boys to be educated, because you are disempowering him. He thrives off that system. Just like the people that have been in politics for a long time, they don't want you young, vibrant people to just be able to come into the Senate. You know, you start to upset a balance. So imagine that they would actually give you that power. It's very, very tough. I think, and I like what they're doing. They're fighting for it. You know, they're pushing, and I encourage them. I think they should keep going. We need people like that to keep championing that. But, and also, so it's not a if or and, you know, it's something where we need a vanguard. We need a movement, yeah, that becomes so large that if the political party refuses to deal with you, then that your demography will go to a party that will respect them and they will win. That's the focus. I personally, this is my own focus. I think they should also keep that focus. But my own focus is that we galvanize the working class. And the working class is not just you are working in GTB. Working class is a driver that's coming to work every morning. The working class is an Okada rider that's riding his bike under the rain and he's suffering. And you can talk to him and you see, when you talk to him, you realize that you guys are on the same wavelength and he wants a better Nigeria. He's working. Not the area boy that sits down drinking shekpe in the morning. You understand? So this working class, we galvanize them. From the young man that is 17 years old in SS2 to the guy that's in first year university, the guy that's graduated, all of that, that is a huge amount of people. Because those are people that will go out and go and get a voter's card by themselves. They'll remember, they'll do their TVC, they'll remember to get their voter's card. So we galvanize them and build a movement that not just pushes for youth to take over, but people of principle, people of ethics, people that, you know, will go in and actually transform this place. Now, that mass of people will be able to push these current political elite to do our bidding, because they will want us to vote for them, you know. But if we don't, and the political system is constantly controlled by they themselves, they won't need to listen to you, because in their minds, they believe that on election day, you won't even turn out anyway. So why are they listening to you? Because a lot of young people, a lot of Nigerians want to go to America, go to England. But you're going to go and reap where you did not sow. In the sense that it was young people that pushed the French Revolution. It was young people that... Greenfield Tower fell, I think, like 2-3 months ago. It burned to ashes. There was a clip of young people going into their council and, like, anger. That is it. Governance has to be two-way. You people have to be serious for governance to work. You cannot just expect that things be handed to you. You have to fight to take it. And that's a major part of why I worked and joined KOWA Party. Because it's not just about a young person going to an established status quo party. There's very little you can do there. Well, APC has not delivered. I mean, I've lived in this place for so many years, and Lagos State has APC or AD or AC has always been in control of Lagos, right? And local government has always been deplorable. They have not delivered. A lot of people don't believe that local government is actually doing anything. That's why they don't even come out. That's why they don't even come out to vote. How many local government people that were running came to come and tell us what their manifesto is? How many of them? It's just rally, jamboree. You cannot find any document that shows what their manifesto is. Yet the place is such a deplorable state. There's so much to do, but there's nothing that they can really say that they are going to do. You know, so they haven't delivered in that regard. You see, APC is strong like this because we, in our generation, that want change, and obviously we are not ready to do the work. We want to spend time chatting in WhatsApp groups, we want to tweet, we want to talk on Facebook. If we came out and actually did the work, going into communities, you know, fumigating the place, cleaning the place, having symposiums with young men, giving young people hope, showing that you actually care, teaching people about good governance, letting people understand the link between them not voting and the flooding that is happening in their area, which also happened on that same Saturday. There were so many places where the waters were as high as waist high that people could not even come out of their house if they wanted to. My brother, it's not, if we did that work, it's not just be something where APC will just have a walkover. No. We just have to decide whether we want to do the work or not.